Let's try an access control list, a filter list here. Let's just do one service. I've set this thing up in a simplified, I hope, infrastructure. Would have over here a computer representing our private network, whatever it is, our firewall router, the router that we're going to configure as a firewall, our filter router, our quote public network unquote, out here in our service. Let's just do one service to start with, actually two services, web and DNS. Let's do web first. First of all, to demonstrate with no access control list, and if I go to the router, let me get it back in here, and go to the command, and I put some routes on here, I'll show you those in just a second. Show access lists, there are none. So right now, this router is not filtering, it's not acting as a firewall, it's just forwarding everything. So if I go to my private, go here and bring my machine back in, this is the PC0, the computer that represents the private network, and if I go here and go to HTTP 172.16.1.3, which is the address of this other guy, it goes through. I've also named it web.skyline.edu, and that goes through. It just doesn't show anything. I guess we can close it and open it and see if it really works. web.skyline.edu, and it comes back. This is what shows up for the Cisco web server. It's there. It's incorporated into the thing. So if I want to restrict some access here and then allow some access, we've talked about the established and we'll put that on. What we want to do is to allow traffic to go from this computer PC0 through router 0 to the web server. The way we do that is simply allow to traffic with a source address of 192.168.1.2 with a destination address, we'll do the web server first, of port 80 to go to 172.16.1.3. That would be our first rule. And if you'll remember, when we establish, make, apply the first rule, any rule, to an interface on a Cisco router, then it automatically applies the deny any at the end. I'm going to use the extended access control list, and the way I'm going to apply this is in the access control list is applied based upon the man in the middle of the router. So if we pretended that we were standing here in the router, N would be coming into the router, N would be coming into the router on any of the interfaces, out would be going out from the interfaces, from the router out to the rest of the world. You can apply them in any direction that you want, and it's going to be a two-step process. So the first thing we want to do, and I'm going to do this and see if I can not screw it up. The first thing we want to do is an access control list. So we're going to config T access list, and extended access lists have to be 100 or above, let's say 101. And what we're going to do is permit 192.168.1.0.0.0.255, the wildcard, because that's the way it should be. And what we're going to do is permit TCP because, well, let's go back and do this, start this thing over. Permit, and let's use the question mark just so that we know what we're going to do. Permit, and we can permit EIG, RP, ESP, GRE, ICMP, IP, OSPF, TCP, or UDP. So in this case, we're going to permit TCP 192.168.1.0. And then if we do the question mark, it's going to tell us the wildcard bits. It'll be 0.0.0.255. In this case, don't care. The zeros don't care. Or excuse me, we do care. We want to look at 192. We're going to check to be sure that the bits are 192, 168, 1, and the 255, the ones don't care. Anything in that range. And the next thing we would put in here, if we do the question mark, is going to be the TCP port. Since we could do greater than 1023 or whatever we wanted, if we wanted a source port, if we leave it blank, it'll be any port. So the next thing would be the destination. The destination is 172.16.1.3, and it's going to be host. So we could do that with either the wildcard mask, or we could do host 172.16.1.3, and then the port equal to the port here. We're going to do equal to www. You could do 80 or www. It's going to interpret it as www. So now we have done the first list. Do show access lists. Permit TCP, The next thing we have to do is apply it. And we want to apply it. I'm going to apply it inbound on FA00, this interface right here. So if I go back to this thing and I go to the interface, config T, INTFA0/0, and it'd be IP access group, the same number as the access list, 101, in. All right? In or out. Now it's applied. Shouldn't work. We'll see if it works. Let's bring it down here and see if we can get to 172.16.1.3. It goes through, so it's letting the traffic back and forth. So it's letting it in. I didn't think it, well, the reason it lets it back is because we haven't applied anything on this list, on this interface here. So anything can still get routed through this interface. The only thing that we've filtered is going out. So the next thing that we need to do is go into let's say access list 102, permit, and we can do this, and let's permit established. Gotta do it the same way. Permit what? And again, we're gonna have to tell it, specify the protocol. In this case, we'll do TCP, and then we need any, because we're gonna use established. The source will be any, the destination any, and then established. Once we've done that, we should have stopped everything else from coming in. And the way we can check that is to go back to this guy, and we can go to 172.16.1.3, and it should work. It does, going in and out. We have the TCP established. If we tried to go to, we haven't allowed it out yet, web.skyline.edu. Let's go with that again. We're waiting. The reason we're waiting is we're now trying to do DNS. We didn't let DNS out in our access control list. We can fix that by simply going to this, back to this router, router 0, and we're going to do show access lists. Lists, got to spell it right. Does. It's not does, it's do. And it says that permit TCP, and you notice here for this one going through equal to www, going to the IP address, we have 10 matches. It's allowed the traffic to go through, and then the established should allow that traffic back in. We really hadn't tried it yet, but we don't have anything here for DNS, so we can simply add to, and if we add to, just it will add it to the bottom of the list. Permit, and then this is going to be UDP 192.168.1.0.0.0.255, and going to host 172.16.1.3 equal to, and this one is domain. You could use port 53. permit. Yeah, I got to tell it what it is, don't I? Access. List 101 likes that better. Still not going to work because we've allowed it out. Let's go step by step, and we'll go host names unresolved. Okay, we let it out. It came back in. So we got there now that we can allow it out. I didn't think it would allow it back in because I haven't allowed. I didn't think anyway. Oh, I know why. Why didn't this do anything yet? Duh. Because I haven't applied access list 102 yet. So if we do show access lists, do show, still can't spell, can I? We have one match going out. We still don't have anything in here. So let's go to do show IP interface brief. The 172 is an interface, so let's go to INTFA0/1, the inbound one, and access IP, access group 102 in. Now that we've applied it, if we go back to this guy, let's go back and start it over. We're going to do web.skyline.edu. Nothing's happening. It's going out, but it's not coming back in because we've applied that access list. If we go to 172.16.1.3, the IP address goes in and out because we've allowed the established. Just to see if that works, now we've applied the access list. Let's show access lists and permit. We went out with the IP address, we went out with the request, the query for DNS, but it didn't come back. We have a permit established with three matches come back. UDP is not a TCP resource, so the established won't let it back in. Let's add that to our access list 102, which is already applied, so we can go to config T. Access list 102, right? And it's applied in, so we're going to allow UDP back in. So we're going to permit UDP, the source 172.16.1.3. And in this case, we have to specify the source IP address, or the source IP address, the source port, because this is not an any. This is going to originate from the UDP port. So we'll say equal to 53, and the destination is going to be 192.168.1.0.0.0.255, and this should be equal to any, but it still wants me to tell it which UDP 192.168.1.0.0.255. Guess I should continue to use that question mark. I have to specify either an address or a host. I didn't give it a wildcard mask. So I said, I don't really like that. So we'll go host 172.16.1.3 equal to domain. And the destination 192.168.1.0.0.0.255. I'm really good at doing it, I think, with the networks, but not necessarily with the host. You can use a 0.0.0.0 for the mask, or simply type the word host. Now then, it finally has taken that, so if I could still spell, show access lists, and we permitted this thing. So now let's go back and see if I can make a fool out of myself and see if this one will now allow me to go to web.skyline.edu, and it does. And if I go back to the router and show access lists, it says that it's permitted 25 matches now getting to the web page. 6 matches getting to the DNS server. one of them came back down here. So one of them came back. So what we have to do is service by service, interface by interface, step by step, permit the stuff to go in and out. I hope this has been useful as you go through these things. I have put some routes in here, and if you want to look at those easily, readily, things that you weren't able to do, you can go into the config and do static. You can put the routes in here. What I've done is just set the default route from this router goes to this interface. This one's already here. I didn't configure anything to get to it, but once you start configuring this router, once you put the access control list on it, just like the other one, it will stop everything except what you permit. This one now has the access control list that allows these machines on this network, however many we would have, to get to this web server in the DMZ, and allows the web server to answer them back. If you want to do the publics, we would let any to go through here, and then we would let the answer come back through this interface. We'd have to do the same thing for DNS that we did with the other one, to allow it, DNS to come through, and then to allow its source port to come back through, since it's not a TCP protocol. And TCP is the only one that the established is going to work for. I'm going to stop now and post this and send you get it posted and see if it's helpful to you. Hope it's useful.